The Nicole Sandler Show, live Monday through Thursdays at 10 a.m. Eastern, or podcast anytime at radioornot.com.
Travel 4 miles and never leave LA.
Oh, the wonderful sounds of Michelle Shocked, actually. Let's play it for a few seconds. You know, one of my all-time favorite songs, it's called Come a Long Way. That version of the song was recorded live in a radio studio back in 1994. The radio station was in Los Angeles. It was KSCA FM 101.9. I got to say, the high point of my career, best time of my life, a wonderful radio station that allowed us to play great artists like Michelle Shocked. And have them in the studio and where they could perform real music. And so with that, it was the first time I had ever interviewed Michelle that day, and we forged a friendship of sorts. Leading up to the last time I spoke to her, which was a little over a year ago when she took part in Occupy the Rose Bowl Parade, and I was filling in for Randy Rhodes. I'm Randy's regular guest host. By the way, I'll be in for her all next week. And Michelle came on the show to talk about her political activism. Well, today, let's just call her. Let's get Michelle Shocked on the line. This is going to be the first time we're hearing from Michelle in person since what happened on Sunday night in San Francisco at Yoshi's.
Hi, thanks for your call. Please leave a message.
And I get her voicemail. All right. I know Michelle was listening earlier, and she's saying, okay. She said, Nicole, you played that song in the last broadcast. Thank you. On Twitter. Michelle, I'm calling again. Please pick up the phone. And hopefully she'll answer.
Hi, thanks for your call.
And again, we're getting voicemail. Michelle, I'm going to text you the number, and there are a lot of people here listening on four different streams waiting to hear your explanation of what happened. Now, I know Michelle has been, tweeting, but the tweets are cryptic, and people want to hear what you have to say. So, again, I'm texting you. The phone number, if you want to call me. She's saying, all right, the photo was so old. I'm not going to sit here and read your tweets, Michelle. Either, you know, you answer the phone call, and I'm dialing again, or, you know, I'll read our text conversation from last night, and I'll play the full audio from Yoshi's. I mean, I don't know what else to do. If you won't come on and defend yourself, if you won't come on and answer the questions as you have told everybody you would, I don't know what else I can do. So we'll give it a few more minutes. Michelle is not answering the phone. We'll try again. And if she doesn't pick up, then we'll go through the audio of what happened Sunday night.
Hi, thanks for your call, please.
You know, it's not like she's sleeping. I know, Michelle, I know you're on Twitter, and I know you're listening. All right, well, Lynn, let's do this. There have been lots of reports about what happened a Sunday night at Yoshi's. This is how it started.
Reality could include some gospel.
You know, let me step in here a second and say, I did see one picture. She's saying, I'll be here on Twitter, right here at Truth Versus Reality. That doesn't work. I want to know what you mean about Truth Versus Reality. I know that on the stage, Michelle Shocked had three signs behind her. Said, the first one said Truth, the middle one said Versus, the last one said Reality. And she was obviously trying to make a point. It didn't work. Michelle, I'm not going to read your tweets. If you want to pick up the phone, then we will talk. We went through this last night via a very weird text conversation. And if I have to, I'll read the text conversation too. Michelle, you know, you're the one who suggested coming on the show. Your exact words were, hold on, let me pick it up because I certainly don't want to misquote you. She said, "Hey, Nikki, after all you've done for me over the years, I owe you that interview." Now, I don't think I've done very much to you other than give me, then interview you and be a fan of yours. Okay, and so, I'm not going to read her tweets. It doesn't work that way. All right, so, here's what happened.
Reality could include some gospel.
Apparently in response to a request for gospel. Okay.
Any other lovers of invisible men in here? This is sincerely the two things that I'm passionate about, y'all. I love me some Jesus, and I love liberation. And I did not know how I was going to come to San Francisco and authentically represent both.
All right, so Michelle Schacht says that, you know, she didn't know how she was going to come to San Francisco and authentically represent both her love of Jesus and her love of liberation. Okay, all right, explain. And then she goes on to tell this great story about Georgia O'Keeffe and how Georgia O'Keeffe believed in God. Now, I'll inject myself in here because... you know, Michelle Schacht is standing me up and backing out of our interview, it seems. I'll try calling her again. Give her a chance. And no, Michelle, I'm not going to read your tweets. I'm an atheist. I came to this viewpoint after being, being raised in a non-religious and a secular Jewish family. I believe in spirituality. I believe in the power of the universe. I believe if you put good things out there, that good things come back. This one tweet I will read, that is a bootleg. It doesn't fucking matter. It's a recording of what you said. And these are your words. I read earlier the statement you put out yesterday. Maybe I'll read this again. Well, let's hear a little bit more and then hear what you said and how it doesn't jive. You know, Michelle, and this is what I said to Michelle Schacht last night via our text exchange. I feel like she's really trying to commit career suicide, and it's upsetting because there are a lot of people, myself included, who have liked her, who have been fans of hers for years, who know that this is not the Michelle Schacht that I hear, and I believe there are certain things in this rant that you know, that don't sound like her. And I think she was trying to make a point that people's truth may be different from the reality around them. But the cryptic tweets are not helping. And Michelle, I'm talking right to you because I know you're listening. They're making you look worse. You have an opportunity to come out and clear up what you were trying to say. If you don't take it, you're going to have a lot of people who basically just write you off. No, it doesn't matter that it's a bootleg. It is. I know you don't like people recording your shows, but they're your words. It's what you said. This is, if you won't come on and talk about it, this is the only thing we have to go by. Before yesterday, we had people's accounts. And honestly, I spoke with a man, the guy who, Mr. Bungo, I think is his Twitter handle, who got up and played harmonica with you. And he wanted to give you the benefit of the doubt. He thought you were trying to make a point, and it got jumbled and it got lost because there was a mob mentality in the crowd that didn't want to give you the chance to explain yourself. But you got angry. And excuse the pun, but this holier-than-thou attitude really doesn't work because you're coming across as a major homophobe. In fact, you know, let's go back to an interview you gave When was it? It might have been at some point, and I lost it. But the quote was, "You're looking at the world's biggest homophobe." You said, 2 years ago you said this. You said this into a public microphone. So what does that mean? In a 1990 interview, you admitted to a lesbian relationship. Is it a self-loathing thing that's going on? Are you having trouble reconciling your newfound religious evangelism with the fact that, you know, you're a person who loves all people, but your church tells you something that goes against the grain? Were you trying to make that difference of truth versus reality? Until you come on the air, let people hear your voice and clarify what you meant, all we have is, you know, the words you said. And if you won't come on and explain it, we'll continue listening to the words. So this is the part that got people to go, huh?
I was in a prayer meeting yesterday. And you got to appreciate how scared folks on that side of the equation are. I mean, from their vantage point, and I really shouldn't say there, because it's mine too.
Okay, that's where, you started off okay. With their vantage point, I really shouldn't say there because it's mine too.
We are nearly at the end of time. And from our vantage point...
From our vantage point...
We're going to be... I think maybe Chinese water torture is going to be the means, the method. Once Prop 8 gets instated, and once... preachers are held at gunpoint and forced to marry the homosexuals.
Okay, first of all, Prop 8 is in force, hopefully not for long. What Prop 8 did is outlaw same-sex marriage. So, Michelle, you're a smart woman. Did you get your facts mixed up? Nobody's going to be, forced to marry anybody at gunpoint.
And forced to marry the homosexuals.
The homosexuals.
I'm pretty sure that will be the signal for Jesus to come on back.
What? Right?
You said you wanted reality.
You said you wanted reality. Is that reality, Michelle? You think that, in 2 weeks, the Supreme Court is going to hear a challenge to Prop 8 and a challenge to the Defense of Marriage Act, which, by the way, Bob Ney, in the last hour, former Congressman Bob Ney, just talked about how John Boehner is raising money. He wants to raise $3 million to fight the efforts to overturn the Defense of Marriage Act. Michelle Schacht is tweeting. I guess if you want to read what she has to say, you can follow her Twitter stream. Michelle Schacht told me she would come on the show for an interview. I am not going to read her tweets. Michelle Schacht, there are thousands of people listening right now, and more will listen to the archives of the show when it's posted after the show ends. If you want to be understood, if you want people to get what you were trying to say, what your truth versus reality stuff is all about, come on and answer the question. Here's the rest of this part. Because this is the part, up to this point, the crowd was with her. The challenges are next week on Tuesday and Wednesday. Are the challenges to DOMA and Prop 8. Thank you, Sean Smith Pierce, Randy Rhodes producer. That's great, because next week, by the way, I'm doing two shows. I'll be doing my show all week in the morning, and I'm in for Randy Rhodes all afternoon. All right, so again, here's the part that got people angry.
I was in a prayer meeting yesterday, and you got to appreciate how scared folks on that side of the equation are. I mean... From their vantage point, and I really shouldn't say there, because it's mine too, we are nearly at the end of time. And from our vantage point, we're going to be, I think maybe Chinese water torture is going to be the means, the method. Once Prop 8 gets instated, and once preachers are held at gunpoint and forced to marry the homosexuals, I'm pretty sure that that will be the signal for Jesus to come on back. You said you wanted reality. If someone would be so gracious as to please tweet out, Michelle Schock just said from stage, God hates faggots. Would you do it now?
Would you do it now? You know, again, this is why I've been so conflicted this week, because I've been trying to give Michelle Schacht, somebody who I've really liked for 25 years, the benefit of the doubt. Because I'm listening to this and saying, you know, that thing, obviously, you know, she's being sarcastic and a bit flippant there. But she's in San Francisco, for God's sake, and there are people taking it seriously. And you have the opportunity to explain yourself, but the responsibility. I'll read other people's tweets. Kim Beavers says, you cannot speak hate with love. I'm shocked that you won't come on with me. Let's listen to the rest of this recording, and then if you choose not to join me, then I'll read our private tweet conversation from last night, because it really saddens me. I am trying to give you an opportunity. I'm trying to fucking help you, and you just don't get it. I'll tell you, Michelle, if you don't come on today, if you don't answer and explain what was going on, and obviously you're trying to make a point, explain the point, then I hope you check in somewhere and get help, because you are committing career suicide, and I'm afraid that it's going to go further than that. All right, so here, Michelle, I guess, going on, I'm going in order from this tape. Yes, she says it's a bootleg. Doesn't matter. It's a recording of the incident that happened at Yoshi's Sunday night that caused, the headlines, Michelle Schacht goes on a virulent anti-gay rant. Here's what she says. And, here.
I ain't scared. This is not a tribunal. This is one woman's opinion. And it's fun. It's a lot of fun.
You know, she's saying that now I'm making threats. I'm not making threats. No, in fact, this is the reality. I am trying to help you. If you won't help yourself, there's nothing more I can do. I guess your words will have to stand for themselves.
I ain't scared. This is not a tribunal. This is one woman's opinion. And it's fun. It's a lot of fun. I am so committed to loving each and every soul in this room tonight.
Really?
No. I could not come here and ignore you. I could not come here and pretend that I was above the conversation.
Okay, so right there you had a responsibility, or the opportunity, to say, I don't agree with the hateful stance of my church. But you didn't.
And I couldn't pretend that I was beneath it either. I had to join it.
What?
And I couldn't pretend that I was beneath it either. I had to join it. Thank you for that one hand clap. I do that all the time. Matter of fact, I was in church it's come to a bad point when the white girl is sitting in a black church. I'm clapping. And a man in front of me turns around and goes, that's irritating. Hallelujah.
Okay, there are calls for me to read the open letter. I actually did in the first hour, but I will again. So yesterday, I got word of an open letter that Michelle Schacht had released to the press to address this. This letter came out before we heard the recording. But let me read to you what she said. I do not nor have I ever said or believed that God hates homosexuals or anyone else. I said that some of his followers believe that. Actually, that's not what you said, Michelle. What you said was,
reality could include some gospel.
Cueing a little bit.
Any other lovers of invisible men in here?
Okay, it's not that clip. Sorry.
I was in a prayer meeting yesterday, and you got to appreciate how scared folks on that side of the equation are. I mean, from their vantage point, and I really shouldn't say there, because it's mine too.
It's yours too.
We are nearly at the end of time. And from our vantage point...
From your vantage point...
We're going to be... I think maybe Chinese water torture is going to be the means, the method. Once Prop 8 gets instated, and once preachers are held at gunpoint and forced to marry the homosexuals, I'm pretty sure that will be the signal for Jesus to come on back.
To me, and unless you talk to us and contradict that is you saying these things. You are speaking for yourself. You said to me. You said I shouldn't say they because I believe it too. Exact words. Okay. All right. When I said Twitter that Michelle Schott says God hates faggots, I was predicting the absurd way my description of my apology for the intolerant would no doubt be misinterpreted. I don't hear any apology for the intolerant. I hear you sounding intolerant.
It's the method. Once Prop 8 gets instated, and once preachers are held at gunpoint and forced to marry the homosexuals, I'm pretty sure that will be the signal for Jesus to come on back.
I'm pretty sure. You are pretty sure.
You wanted reality. Someone would be so gracious as to please tweet out, Michelle Schock just said from stage, God hates faggots. Would you do it now?
You can have your show, Michelle.
At least some people's gods.
All right. Those are her words, I guess. All right. She just tweeted, I am talking to you. This is how you're talking, Michelle. These are your words. I guess we need to take you at face value. So, you know, again, trying to give her the benefit of the doubt, which is becoming more and more difficult with each passing moment. When I heard this clip, I thought, all right, why is nobody picking up on this?
I'd like to play some songs, but...
I hope you get wise, Michelle, and realize that there's nothing to fear. There's nothing to fear. Everybody is deserving of your, whoever your God is, his love.
Can I respond to that off the microphone?
Why not on the microphone?
Respond to it on the microphone.
I am sick of Christians filled with hypocrisy hiding behind the symbol of a cross.
Come on, show it. Show your true self. Come on.
Confused.
Can you clarify?
Come on,
Michelle.
Say what you mean.
What are you afraid of?
I believe that the Word of God is just what it says it is.
Oh, dear God.
The truth.
You're a literalist?
What?
Have you heard the Word of God? So is God talking to you? Again, Michelle... the only thing we have to go by are these words. Your letter, your open letter continues. Let's see. And to those fans who are disappointed by what they've heard or think I said, I'm very sorry. I don't always express myself as clearly as I should. But don't believe everything you read on Facebook or Twitter. My view of homosexuality has changed not one iota. I judge not. And my statement equating repeal of Prop 8 with the coming of the end times was neither literal nor ironic. It was a description of how some folks, not me, feel about gay marriage. But Michelle, that's not what you said. You said it is my opinion, too.
I was in a prayer meeting yesterday, and you got to appreciate how scared folks on that side of the equation.
You started out saying that.
I mean, from their vantage point, and I really shouldn't say their, because it's mine too.
It's yours too.
We are at nearly at the end of time. And from our vantage point, we're going to be...
From your vantage point?
I think maybe Chinese water torture is going to be the means, the method. Once Prop 8 gets instated, and once preachers are held at gunpoint and forced to marry the homosexuals, I'm pretty sure that that will be the signal for Jesus to come on back. You said you wanted reality. If someone would be so gracious as to please tweet out, Michelle Schock just said from stage, God hates faggots. Would you do it now?
All right, so, you know, apparently, according to Michelle, I'm distorting her words. No, I'm just playing her words, her exact words. Back to the open letter, because it's all I've got. Let's try to call her again, see if she'll pick up. I want her to clarify. Michelle, if I'm distorting your words, pick up the fucking phone and talk to us.
Hi, thanks for your call. Please leave a message.
Nope. Okay. All right, so it continues. And my statement equating repeal of Prop 8 with the coming of the end times was neither literal nor ironic. It was a description of how some folks, not me, feel about gay marriage. That's not what you said. Clarify, please. Not on Twitter, not in 140 characters, but on the phone, on the air with me, as you said you would. All right. Then it continues. The show and the rant was spontaneous. As for those applauding my so-called stance that, quote, God hates faggots, I say this should be met with mercy, not hate. And I hope that what remains of my audience will meet that intolerance with understanding, even of those who might hate them. Folks wonder about my sexuality, but denying being gay is like saying I never beat my husband. My sexuality is not at issue. What is being questioned is my support for the LGBT community, and that has never wavered. Music and activism have always been part of my work and my journey. Yeah, which I hope and intend to continue. I'd like to say this was a publicity stunt, but I'm really not that clever, and I'm definitely not that cynical. But I am damn sorry. If I could repeat the evening, I would make a clearer distinction between a set of beliefs I abhor and my human sympathy for the folks who hold them. I say this not because I want to look better. I have no wish to hide my faults, and clearly, I couldn't if I tried. With love, Michelle. You now have an opportunity to clarify what you mean, because the words that we heard from that tape recording do not jive with this open letter that you sent out. You have an opportunity. People, I guess from around the world, have tuned in to hear your explanation, to give you a chance, and instead you're playing a game on Twitter. I think you need to step away from the Twitter. I think you need to get on the phone and answer the questions, because you got a lot of people who are giving you a chance. There are a lot of people who've already walked away and said, fuck her. She's a homophobe. You know, she's done. So there are those of us who, you know, who still want to hear from you, who want to give you a chance to clear it up, to explain what you meant. You're doing this whole truth versus reality thing. Explain it. You have a platform. Michelle.
You need to get on the phone and answer the question.
Okay, so I'm hearing myself playing back. Michelle, turn down the computer, because I'm hearing myself coming back. Obviously, you picked up the phone. Turn down the sound on the computer and talk to us.
So for those of us who, you know, who don't want to hear from...
Michelle, turn down the sound on the computer. The old turn down the radio thing?
You have a platform.
Michelle, turn down the radio.
I did.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for picking up. All right, thank you for picking up, and thank you for talking to us. Michelle Schacht is with us. I hear what you said. I heard your apology, but you heard the recording. So, you know, you did say in there that it's not just their views, it's their mind, too.
Yeah,
Now, you've been doing this truth versus reality thing. Do you want to explain what that means? Because we don't know. Michelle, turn down the radio and listen in the phone.
I believe in a God who loves everyone.
You believe in a God who loves everyone. Then why did you say what you said? Turn down the radio. Turn off the computer. You got to listen in the phone. Michelle, turn down the computer. Listen via the phone and talk to us, please.
I believe in a God who loves everyone, and my faith tells me to do my best to also love everyone. Everyone, gay or straight, stridently gay, self-righteously faithful, left or right, far left, far right, good, bad, or indifferent. That's the law. Everyone. I may disagree with someone's most fervently held belief, but I will not hate them.
Okay, then were you trying to make a point Sunday night about the difference between some, religious evangelical beliefs and your beliefs? Again, Michelle, listen on the phone. Turn down the computer, please.
And in this controversy, that means speaking for Christians with opinions I in no way share about homosexuality. Will I endorse them? Never. Will I disavow them? Never.
So what about your whole statement about this being your view, too, that if judges are forced at gunpoint to marry homosexuals, that it's end times and Jesus will come back? Did you mean that, or are you just reading to me off your prepared statement? Michelle, talk to us. This is human interaction. It's what you used to be so good at. You would step on a stage. You would tell stories. You would sing great songs that showed compassion and humility. And you would connect with an audience. You're not connecting with anybody now. And yes, I'm worried about you. Are you still there? We're not connected anymore. Let's try again. I think she was reading off her open letter.
Hi, thanks for your call. Please leave a message.
Wow. You know, I feel really sad. I think that Michelle Schacht has had some kind of a nervous breakdown. I think that she's hiding behind some hashtag. I mean, God, this is like a terrible reality show. She's hiding behind this truth versus reality hashtag as if we know what she's talking about. And let me once again put out a plea and say, Michelle Schacht, we don't know what you're talking about. You have an opportunity to explain it. Now, I know, look, there have been interviews with Michelle in recent days and months. Apparently, she's not been able to come to odds with the fact that she has been in a long-term relationship with, from what I understand, a really wonderful man, but that they are, fornicating without wedlock. You know what? This is when spirituality comes in. And again, I am not religious in any way, shape, or form. But I do believe in spirituality. I believe in thinking for myself, which is one of my main problems with organized religion, is that you do not think for yourself. No, she's saying, hiding behind a hashtag, I'm right here. You won't fucking talk to us. You're not right there. You're not right at all. Michelle, you are, I worry about you because I have a feeling the next thing we're going to hear is that, you know, you're in the hospital after having overdosed. This is your chance to talk about what you mean rather than, you know, talk in generalities or hashtags or 140 characters. I'm going to try calling you again. I know you're listening. Pick up, turn down the sound on the computer, how you're listening, and talk to me like one human being to another.
Hi, thanks for your call. Please leave a...
Or not. You know, she did say this.
I am sick of Christians filled with hypocrisy hiding behind the symbol of a cross.
You know, so am I. So am I. I think some people who hide behind the symbol of the cross are the most heinous excuses for human beings to walk the earth. Pat Robertson should be ashamed of himself. He calls himself a Christian. I, as an atheist Jew, am more Christian on my worst day than he ever will be on his best. He tells the poor people who are hurting financially to give him $20 a month. And he'll send them a DVD of somebody who really died and went to heaven and came back. It's disgusting. He talks about, you know, don't adopt orphans from, you know, from other countries, from orphanages. We don't need that baggage. Ugh, don't take that those troubles into your home. If that's Christian, I want no part of it. And if your church tells you that homosexuality is a sin, then leave the fucking church. And obviously, Michelle, deep down inside you, you know that's the truth. And so you're having trouble reconciling it. And this church that supposedly, according to the interviews I've read with you, you joined for the music and then you stayed for the preaching, obviously it has disconnected something inside you. If the church told you to go jump off a bridge, would you? Yes, I'm a mother. I'm a mother of a child that I adopted from an orphanage in Kazakhstan. Fuck you, Pat Robertson. Don't tell me not to, adopt a child because it might be damaged. That is not Christian. And yet this guy is raking in billions from, you know, poor, naive souls who think if they send him $20, their souls will be saved. No, it's the surest way to lose your soul. And Michelle, I fear that in trying to defend this church who says God hates faggots, your soul is lost. Let's try again.
Hi, thanks for your call.
Nope.
Please leave a message.
All right, now I'm bullying.
Please record your message.
You know, now, okay. So here's the thing. So now Michelle Schacht will be the hero of the Westboro Baptist Church people. That's a hate church. By the way, did you hear about the gay rights activist who bought the house across the street from the Westboro Baptist Church and painted it all the colors of the rainbow? That's love. These words are not love. Just not love. All right, so now hold on, because somebody else is texting me. Where is it? All right, so the friend of hers, the friend of hers who she enlisted to read her statement has been tweeting me that she was rereading the statement. When she was on the phone with me, she wasn't answering my questions. She wasn't talking to me as a human being. She was just reading the statement she released. That's not a conversation. Michelle, again, no to you, evangelicals on Twitter. I'm not bullying her. You know, I guess there's such a thing as tough love, right? And now she's saying her church doesn't say God hates faggots. Again, on Twitter. Really? Then once again,
I was in a prayer meeting yesterday, and you got to appreciate how scared folks on that side of the equation are. I mean, from their vantage point, and I really shouldn't say there, because it's mine too, we are nearly at the end of time. And from our vantage point, we're going to be, I think maybe Chinese water torture is going to be the means, the method.
Note the
once we. Once Prop 8 gets instated, and once preachers are held at gunpoint and forced to marry the homosexuals, I'm pretty sure that that will be the signal for Jesus to come on back. You said you wanted reality. If someone would be so gracious as to please tweet out, Michelle Shock just said from stage, God hates faggots. Would you do it now?
You can have your show, Michelle.
Only some people's gods.
Okay, so let's try to call Michelle again, because she is tweeting to me. And she did say, hold on, let me find it again. She asked me to call her in real time.
Hi, thanks.
I am calling you direct real time. Here's the thing. I call you, there's about a five-second delay between me going out over the interwebs and when it reaches you. I'm trying calling. And actually, when I got her on the phone before, what she did was read the second part of the statement she released to the media that said, I believe in a God who loves everyone, and my faith tells me to do my best to love everyone. Everyone, gay or straight, stridently gay, self-righteously faithful, left or right, far right, good, bad, or indifferent. That's the law, everyone. This is what she was reading when I did get her on the phone. I may disagree with someone's most fervently held belief, but I will not hate them. And in this controversy, that means speaking for Christians with opinions I in no way share about homosexuality. Will I endorse them? Never. Will I disavow them? Never. I stand accused of forsaking the LGBT community for a Christianity which is, hear me now, anathema to my understanding of faith. I will no doubt take future flack for saying so. I'm accused of believing that, quote, God hates fags and that the repeal of Prop 8 will usher in the end times. Well, if I cause such an absurdity, I am damn sorry. To be clear, I am not now, nor have I ever been, a member of any so-called faith preaching intolerance of anyone. Again, anyone, straight or gay, believers or not, that's the law. That means upholding my punk rock values in the most evangelical enclaves, and in this case, speaking up for the most fearful fundamentalists in, well, a San Francisco music hall full of Michelle Shocked fans. As an artist in this time of unbearable culture wars, I understand this means trouble, and this is neither the first nor the last time trouble has come my way, and that's fine by me. I know the fear many in the evangelical community feel about homosexual marriage, as I understand the fear many in the gay community feel toward these self-appointed faithful. I have and will continue speaking to both. Everything else, Facebook, Twitter, whatever, is commentary. Michelle, you can't have it both ways. And I'm sorry, the hateful, call them the faithful if you will, I call them the hateful, the Westboro Baptist Church gang who are sticking up for you right now, and they seem to be the only ones. They are hate-filled. They are not love-filled. And from what I know of Jesus Christ, he would not have stood up for those people. He would have disavowed them. And the thing is, again, as the recording shows, that's not what you said. You said, I'm speaking for myself too. I believe it too.
I was in a prayer meeting yesterday, and you got to appreciate how scared folks on that side of the equation are. I mean, from their vantage point, and I really shouldn't say there, because it's mine too.
Yours too. See, Michelle,
nearly at the end of time.
This is what you need to clarify, because you took ownership of it there. And if that's not what you believe, answer the phone and tell us why you said it. That's the problem. Why did you say that? And it could be, you know what? I was standing on the stage and it turned ugly and I was nervous and my words got jumbled, and that's not what I meant. But you're hiding behind this hashtag truth versus reality, which honestly, my truth is my reality. And my reality is I'm seeing a lot of hate coming from those words. And so answer the phone.
Hi, thanks for your call. Please leave
Amazing.
A message.
Amazing.
At the tone, please record your message when you have...
Amazing. And now she's disavowing the fact that Westboro Baptist Church is her community. And then she says, Occupy! You know what? You can't just say the words. It doesn't make it okay. Just so you know, here's where I am now. And I say this with great sadness. Because, you know, I used to really like and respect Michelle Schacht. Not so much anymore. I think she's hiding behind Twitter. I think she's, how about this? Yes! And she's saying, how about this? I call you and you answer the phone. Do it! I texted you the phone number. Not my cell phone. I texted you the phone number. Call that number. It goes out over the air. Please. I want to hear from you. Because I got to tell you, it's, you know, by you not speaking, it's giving us two possible conclusions. One is that, yeah, you do believe this stuff. Or the second is that you're fucking insane and you really need help. And maybe you need to go to a mental hospital. I don't want to believe either one of those. But, you know, look, I've been going for 50 minutes now trying to get you on the phone. And we went through this via a text message last night. Okay, there she is. All right. Hi, Michelle, it's Nicole. Now, here's the thing. If you're listening on the computer, there is just a delay that's in the system because this is going down the tubes. So, can you hear me?
I can hear you,
Yay.
So I'm going to let the audience hear you explain about this delay.
The delay is because I'm doing a show on the internet. From the time I speak, there's about a 5-second delay until it gets out of your computer speakers. It's
five,
not that unusual.
Two, three, four,
oh my God.
Five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10, 11, 12.
Amazing. Okay, so it's a 12-second delay. You know, that's not what's at the, that's not what the issue is. We're talking live, and you're just trying to divert the attention from what the fuck? Are you a homophobe or not?
17.
Oh, God.
18.
Are you done? Are you there? I told you, turn down the radio.
I want to talk to you in real time. I'll see you on Twitter.
No, you won't. Wow. Wow. Okay. So there you have it. I will, you know, that was it. I guess that's it. We can listen to the end of her rant. This is the end of it. She played a song during which most of the people walked out.
No, don't bother to blow. It's not needed. No, not seriously. I don't think I can handle all the adulation right now. I got a question for you. It's a sincere question.
We don't know your question.
How are you enjoying reality so far?
Wow.
It's not your reality.
Sucks pretty much, doesn't it?
Our reality is okay.
You can't have both. Don't come to San Francisco saying that shit. Let's take that note. I just got a tweet. It says, don't come to San Francisco.
Step away from the Twitter.
Where do I go to say that shit? It is weird. Yeah, it is
your
weird.
Your reality is tweets?
This is not my choice.
Is
According to this show, we spent like 20% of the show on tweets. 80% was a show, and 40% was homophobia.
Get her out of here.
Yeah, I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much for joining us tonight at Yoshi's.
You're pulling the flag to give me a hug, young.
And some people are still trying to hear what she had to say.
I still got game. Should we lose the mic?
Yeah.
All right, I will.
Draw a little closer. When they take away the microphone, you don't want to stay close.
All right, so there you go. And then she plays this song, and after the song, without the mic, she said,
"No, don't bother to applaud. It's not needed. No, no,
whoops, sorry. That's the one. Here's the end of it. Sorry.
I just want y'all to know that I didn't ask for a deposit for this performance, and I have pretty good reason to believe that when I leave here tonight." I'm going to be told that I did not give anyone their money's worth. And so now I would like to pass the hat and ask if you wouldn't mind putting a dollar in for the folk singer, for the busker, for the street performer. And if that's too kind, maybe you'll support my initiative, a songbook with sheet music in it. You can read the words. You can see for yourself between the lines. All I'm trying to say is God bless us, everyone. Thank you for coming.
All right, and some, I guess, still wanted to... yeah, sorry, Michelle. You have no concept of reality. At this point, I really hope you get some help, because I think you need it. I will go out with one song, one more song, that probably, I don't know which one to play. Yeah, maybe I'll play, you know, because this is the last Michelle Shock song I'll play. Maybe it's this one from our first meeting. I'll play it all the way through. Or the first time I interviewed her. Michelle Shocked, I think your career is toast. You had an opportunity to come on and set the record straight. You are paranoid. I'm sorry that you don't understand that when you do a live interview, especially online, yes, there might be some kind of delay. I had no control over the delay. I was trying to give you a voice in more than 140 characters. So you could explain to people like me who were still willing to give you the benefit of the doubt to explain what this crazy truth versus reality nonsense is and to explain what you meant. And instead, you chose to read a release, this open letter that's also jumbled and doesn't make any sense, and to, you know, to stand up for hateful people. And I'm sorry, that just doesn't cut it. On Tuesday and Wednesday of next week, the Supreme Court is going to hear challenges to the Defense of Marriage Act and to Prop 8. I hope they both go down big time. This is 2013. We don't listen to an imaginary man in the sky or an invisible man in the room. We all are entitled to our own religion, our own beliefs, and our own, you're right, reality. And if you choose to go out into that ether land, more power to you. I won't be listening anymore. All right, Michelle, we've come a long way. On that note, to those of you who tuned in today for the first time, I'm sorry you didn't get what you came for. Maybe you leave with the same thoughts that I have right now, and it's a sad one. I feel sad. I hope she gets help. I do a live show here a bit of self-promotion. Monday through Thursday mornings, 10 to noon Eastern, 7 to 9 Pacific. My home site is here, radioornot.com, because it's radio. It's the future of radio, but it's not terrestrial radio. Radioornot.com. I'm also the regular guest host for Randy Rhodes, and I will be filling in for her all next week. So my show in the morning, Randy Rhodes' show in the afternoon. I'll leave you with the last song I'll ever play from Michelle Schacht. It was recorded live in the studio at KSCA in Los Angeles in 1994. It was when she was a caring, compassionate, brilliant, young, promising musician. It's been nice knowing you, Michelle. Thanks for listening, everyone.
Kicked in his door at 5 a.m. I come for my bike, I told the repo man. My 920's gonna take me far today. You can travel 4 miles and never leave L.A. Wearing no clothes, I heard the screams of the dying dogs through the sweet green eyes in a MacArthur Park. And then I crossed the river into East LA, Stella Mahalani and Cole. And I'm giving up on rock and roll, and I'm saving up for North Daniel. And then she rides by the railroad tracks, where I'll never take it back. There's been a train, she cries on her midnight.
Seriously? Seriously? Hold on, because we're still on the air. You want to talk?
Shame on you.
Shame on me? Shame. We're still on the air, by the way. Shame on me? You told
shame
me.
On you.
How is it shame on me?
Shame on you. Shame on you.
Okay, why? Why?
You're exposed.
Excuse me?
You are exposed.
I'm exposed? How am I exposed?
Yes.
Exposed as what?
The truth is on Twitter.
No. What's on Twitter are nonsensical little hashtag 140 character nonsensical tweets that you're sending out that don't mean anything. You've had an opportunity to speak, to tell what was going on. There were many of us who wanted to give you a chance. Talk.
I'll talk, I'll say it 5 times so that it can catch up with your delay.
Don't worry about the delay. You're the only one hearing the fucking delay. We're speaking. Human beings, talk.
Shame on you. Your agenda is exposed.
What is that agenda? Please tell me.
You claim to be defending the truth?
Yeah.
Ending the status quo.
You know what? Quit speaking in sound bites that don't mean anything. What is your agenda?
Don't accuse me of being in sound bites. You've parsed, and you've cut up, and you've dissected my intentions and my words, and you've done it with a bootleg, and you want to put it on a podcast.
God.
Good luck with that.
You know what? It is a recording of the words that came out of your mouth. I played it in order. I cut nothing out except the music. The entire thing is posted on my website, should anybody care to listen, and it's all over the internet. She hung up. And it doesn't matter whether it's a bootleg or not. You don't authorize anyone to record your shows. But we deserve to hear exactly what you said, and we did. And obviously, you don't want to defend yourself. Instead, you say, shame on me? No, Michelle. Shame on you. Really, shame on you. We'll finish the song and I'm done.
bay. Watch my ship sail in, I watch it sail away.